Ganon. Madali tayong maniwala. Andaling tating maloko. Hello, magandang gabi po at kumusta po kayo? At sana nasa mabuting kalagayan po kayo. And then pasalamat tayo sa Diyos at pasalamat tayo sa ating mahal na bispo sa Diocese of Talibon, si Bishop Patrick Daniel Parcon, na dahil pumunta tayo sa Alicia, Bohol. Dumaan tayo kay Bishop sa Diocese of Talibon. Salamat Bishop sa mga magandang insights, mga inspiration, mga advices, mga reminders na makatulong sa atin. It is a great reminder, no? Mas maganda na yung mga tatay natin sa pananampalataya ay laging gumagabay sa atin. Okay? And then, pasalamat din tayo sa pamilya Galon sa Valencia, sa Alicia po, dahil doon tayo nakatulog. And then, pasalamat tayo sa mga kasamahan natin na mga exorcist sa Diocese of Talibon. Sila si Reverend Father Ray Umamalin, Reverend Father Julius Asukan, Reverend Aster Felicilda, at si hindi nakadalo si Father Alex Oxtero, dahil puno yung schedule niya. At ngayon mga kapatid, patuloy tayo sa pag-discern, no? Kailangan natin ito. Merong mga, ang dami pala nito. Pero, magbasa lang tayo para ma-share ninyo. And then, dahan-dahan din ay mga basic guidelines in discerning private revelation. Dahil, merong makatanggap sa atin ng mga private revelation. Ang dami na. Diba? Paano ba natin ma-discern na ito is from God, from evil one, or from sa sarili lang natin? So, nandito po tayo, hindi magtuligsa ng ibang tao, kundi sabi lang natin ang katotohanan po. Okay? Because we care for you. We care your soul. We care, it is all about pastoral care, no? Amen? Merong how to guidelines, no? Meron itong dalawa, marami tayong tatlo. So, mataas tayong tatlo. Una, the first point of the inquiry is centered on the person of the visionary or the mystic. So, focus ito sa, kung merong mga, ito maganda po ito dahil kalimitan sa atin po ay ang daling maniwala. No? Kung isang tao ay pinakitaan ng birhen, pinakitaan ng anghel, pinakitaan ng mahal na birhen, ganon. Madali tayong maniwala. Andaling tating maloko. So, una, the first point of the inquiry is centered on the visionary, the person who claimed to have visionary. So, tatlo po ah. Pwede galing sa Diyos, no? Pwede galing sa sa demonyo, pwede din gawa-gawa lang niya. Galing sa sarili niya. What are his natural qualities, both positive and negative? Check the state of his body and mind. What also are his moral qualities? So, tingnan mo ng buo. No, hindi lang yung negative qualities niya, kundi yung positive qualities niya. And then, check the state of his body and mind. No? Kung masakitin yan, may mga hallucination yun, di ba? And then, especially his moral qualities. Example, yung visionary ay lalaki pero nagdadamit na pang babae. Karong po yun. Sasabihin na, ito yung sugo ng mahal na ina na magsuot daw ako. So, how, basic guidelines po. Ang una, i-examine natin yung person who claim to have a vision, who claim to have to talk to God directly. So, una, the moral qualities sa person, sa tao na pinakitaan ng berhen, no? sa persona niya. No? Kung yung moral qualities niya ay maganda, yan, magandang pangitain yan. Has this person been known to be sincere, cold-headed, no? Sincere, makita mo yung kanyang sinseridad. No, sa kanyang taos puso. Cool-headed, hindi puno ng sakit sa ulo, madaling magalit, and of sound judgment. Kung may judgment siya, it is sound, no? It is fair, no? Hindi judgmental. Yan, isa yan sa mga palatandaan na dapat i-discern natin yung merong private revelation. Guided by reason, not by impressions. Ano ang dapat narason? We are guided by reason, not by impressions, not by our emotion. So, paano natin na we are guided by reason? No? So, grounded to the teaching of the church. Okay? Is his mind sound or does he suffer from mental disorder? Baka, may sakit sa utak. So, yan ang isa sa mga consideration to discern private revelation that this person is authentic or not. A psychiatric evaluation would be of invaluable assistance in this regard. Kung nakikita natin na merong mental illness, kailangan natin ng psychiatrist, no? Does he has any illness that may be the cause of what he is experiencing? Yan. So, ini-evaluate natin. Una ito po. Tatlo lang po ito. Pero maraming mga... it is more focused on the person. To the visionary. No? Meron kaming visionary dito. Grabe. No? Akala ko. Ginagamit na yung vision niya. Ikaw mag-donate ka nito. 50,000 pesos. Kung hindi ka mag-donate, may mangyari sa'yo. Mukhang pira na si... tumiwalag na kayo niyan, no? Ano pa? Morally speaking, what virtues does this person possess? Kailangan po yung mga virtues na nasa kanya, no? Kapag walang virtues, hindi po. Kailangan po, no? Yung virtues, no? And we have a theological virtues, di ba? Sa sa Catechism of the Catholic Church, merong cardinal virtues, di ba? Meron ding, tingnan natin, virtues, theological virtues, faith, faith, hope, and charity. Nandyan ba ito sa kanya? Faith, hope, and charity. Meron ding cardinal virtues. Four virtues play a pivotal role accordingly are called cardinal. All the others are grouped around them. They are prudence, justice, fortitude, and temperance. If anyone loves righteousness, labors are virtues. For she teaches temperance and prudence, justice and courage. These virtues are praised under other names and many passages of scripture. Ano yung virtue? One of the cardinal virtues is prudence. Ano ba itong prudence? It's the virtue that disposes practical reason to discern our true good in every circumstance and to choose the right means of achieving it. The prudent man looks where he is going. Keep sane and sober for your prayers. Prudence is a right reason in action. Saint Thomas, right reason in action. Ano yung prudence? Right reason. Yung right reason in action. Yung ginagawa mo, yung katotohanan. Hindi ka magmadali, prudent tayo. Right reason in action, Saint Augustine. Following Aristotle, it is not to be confused with timidity or fear, not with duplicity of this dissimulation. It is called virtutum, the charioteer of the virtues. The charioteer of the virtues. It guides the other virtues by setting rule and measure. It is prudence that immediately guides the judgment of conscience. The prudent man determines and directs his conduct in accordance with his judgment. With the help of his virtue, we apply moral principles to particular cases without error and overcome doubts about the good to achieve and the evil to avoid. So, know the good and avoid the evil. It is a prudence. Justice, ito po yung mga cardinal virtues. Hindi ko na lang i-discuss inyo yung virtues. No? Justice, direct to the point na lang. Moral virtue that consists in constant and firm will to give their due to God and neighbor. What is due to God, what is due to our neighbor will be given rightly. Okay? Nandyan yan sa... binabasa ko yung CCC 10.06 and 10.07. What is due to God will be given to God. What is due to our neighbor? The virtue of religion, justice toward God is called the virtue of religion. Justice toward man disposes one to respect the rights of each and to establish a human relationship and harmony that promotes equity with regard to person and to the common good. So, yan. Masters, treat your slave justly and fairly, knowing that you also have a master in heaven. So, tayong lahat ay may equity, no? So, treat the poor. Treat the poor with justice. Pang-apat yung cardinal virtues. Kung nandyan po yan sa, ano? Yes, no? Ang ganda. Fortitude, the moral virtue that ensures firmness in difficulties. So, ito ang hihingi natin ng Diyos na matibay tayo. Constancy in the pursuit of the good. It strengthens the resolve to resist temptation, to overcome obstacles. In moral life, the virtue of fortitude enables one to conquer fear, even fear of death, and to face trials. Of fortitude, yung hindi na matatakot siya, yan po. And then, hindi mananakot. No? Firm, dahil yung kanyang tiwala ay sa Diyos lang. Okay? And then, temperance. Is moral virtue that moderates The attraction of pollution provides balance in the use of created goods. It is moderation, temperance. So fortitude is all about strength, no? And then justice, to give what is due. And then the first one is prudence, no? In short, according to Saint Augustine, Saint Thomas, what is prudence is right reason in action. So ginagawa mo lagi yung tama, prudence, no? So yan ang cardinal virtues. The theological virtues, may theological virtues tayo. The human virtues are rooted in the theological virtues, which adapt man's faculties for participation in the divine nature. I'm reading CCC 18:12. The theological virtues relate directly to God. This is post-Christians still live in relationship with the Holy Trinity. They have the one and triune God for origin, motive, and object. So, makonect tayo sa origin, motive, and object sa ating Panginoon. Yan po ang faith, no? Theological virtue, believing in God. And then the third one is hope, theological virtue. And then, I will not discuss this further, no? Hindi natin i-discuss yan sa sunod ng mga araw. Kailangan pala yung visionary or mystic, no? Ano yung mga virtues that this person possess? What is the general level of his spiritual life from a standpoint of perfection, both before revelation and afterwards? Father Pauline S.J. states that if before the revelation he was a person of scandalous conduct, it is not likely that God has chosen him as the recipient of his favors, except for purpose of his conversion. But this is rare. And this conversion, I would add, will be a radical one that is evident to all. So, kung scandalous yung buhay niya before and during revelation, magtaka ka na, no? So, yung visionary, yung my private revelation, example, no? yung moral life niya, hinihiwalay niya yung asawa niya. Hinihiwalay niya yung mga anak niya. Nag-focus lang siya sa revelation. Hindi po maganda yon. Huwag na kayong sumunod sa kanya, mga kapatid. It can also be that the person is only of ordinary virtue when God uses him in order to found or start a pilgrimage or to suggest some useful undertaking. For example, the three children of Fatima. The important point, according to Father Pauline S.J., is to know whether there has been much progress after the revelation. Siguro, ordinaryo lang sila. Pero nung nag-reveal sa kanya ang mahal na ina, yung isang santo, ang Panginoon nag-reveal sa kanya, there has been much progress after revelation. So, grabe yung conversion niya, no? After revelation, yan po ay galing sa Diyos. According to him, if a great advance in sanctification has been noticed, and if further there can be attributed to the revelation and not simply to other graces, there is a strong probability in a subject's favor. Katulad ng mga bata sa Fatima. Grabe yung conversion silang si Lucia naging madre. Grabe talaga yung kanilang prayer life, spiritual life. Grabe, tumutubo. Kitang-kita sa marami. But he adds, if on the contrary the seer of the vision has remained an ordinary level of virtue, his vision must be regarded with suspicion, since such extraordinary means are not made use of God to lead a merely ordinary state of self-sacrifice. So if after the revelation a person still continually commits mortal sin, intentional venial sins, the person of the visionary and his supposed revelation are authentically suspect. So, kung yung taong iyon na pinakitaan ng mahal na birhen, yung buhay niya, no? Grabe. Pinakitaan na yung mga mystic na yung mga na nakatanggap ng private revelation, questionable yung buhay niya, may ano siya, may immoral na buhay, questionable yung revelation niya. According to Father Pullen S.J., when it is the devil who is acting, he cannot incline the soul towards solid virtues in a real and durable manner. So, malinaw na malinaw po ito, no? So, kung ang demonyo pala ay mag-as if na Mama Mary, hindi siya solid virtues. Yung virtues niya ay ordinary level of virtue lang. Sabi niya dito, when it is the devil who is acting on that person, he cannot incline the soul towards solid virtues in a real and durable manner. So, mga temporary, superficial lang. Outwardly, the person may seem holy, but that's for example of the person's humility, obedience, and patience by spiritual director will show the reality that this is a merely superficial. Kung itest na ang kanilang humility and obedience, hindi na yan susunod sa spiritual director. Masusunod pa yan sa kanilang spiritual companion. So, mag-ingat po tayo nito. It is a superficial. Superficial. It is not authentic. So, magduda na ka na dyan. Okay? Batuloy tayo. Ang ganda nito, no? When the devil is acting, little by little, one would notice the appearance of exaggeration and oddities, no? Especially in a person, a supposed visionary. This we have seen with the case of Sister Magdalena of the Cross. Father Pauline S.J. states that under the devil's influence, bodily penances will be posed to the length of ruining the health. Exaggeration and oddities. So, kung ang demonyo, exaggeration, grabe yung fasting, grabe yung pagdadasal, no? Kahit hindi ka naman munghe, no? Yan po, exaggerate lahat, no? Yung bodily penances, no, sa anong intention ng demonyo? Bodily penances will be pushed to the length of ruining the health. Para maruin yung and they will be disobedience to lawful superiors. Hindi yan makikinig sa obispo. Nakikinig lang yan, kaunti, pero hindi yan susunod. Okay. Disobedience to the lawful superiors. The devil will make the person ridiculous to those not yet under the influence, or may say, brainwashed by the supposed visionary. So, i-brainwash tayo. A person who has for many years been deceived by false visionary will tend to be blind and will rationalize the inconsistencies and even the scandalous behaviors of the visionary. Example nito, yung kapatid natin, no, sa nagpakilalang Son of God, no. So, will be deceived the false visionary for many years, even though there are scandalous behaviors of the visionary, it would be difficult for him to accept that he has been deceived for so long and wasted so much time, energy and even money to support the mystic. No? Wasted much time, energy, and even money to support the mystic. And of course, the devil will already have had a stronghold in the person's mind and emotion. So, hindi na yan makikinig. Close-minded na po yan. Bakit? May hold na yung demonyo. Stronghold in the person's mind and emotion through hypnotism. Father Pauline, S.G. Father Arch, adds, the purity of conscience will be degenerate into scrupulosity. Yung purity of conscience natin, purity of conscience will be degenerate into scrupulosity. Scrupulosity. Scrupulous na yung conscience mo. Whatever humility present, into sloth and discouragement with zeal will become indiscretion. This, I would say, would be manifested by both the person of the false visionary and mystic and those of his followers. Makontaminate na yung ating konsensya. So, malinaw dito, no? No? Zeal will become indiscretion. Discouragement. Wala na yun. And then sloth. With regard to vocation, the devil is revealed when he tries to make person change their vocation at a time when it cannot be done. For example, inspire a religious to leave his vocation after the person has already made a solemn profession that was properly discerned. Example lang, no? Naintindihan ko dito, example. May asawa ka. And then, ang taas ng oras mo sa pagdasal, no? Magigiba yung pamilya mo. It is not from God. No? According to the author, among those virtues that a revelation should bring in its train, one that should shine forth most brilliantly, and regarding which it is, that is of paramount importance to be informed, the virtue of humility, since it is the one most opposed to our nature, and of which Satan has the greatest horror. So, kailangan, ang pinaka-importante nito, yung virtue of humility. According to the author, pride, on the contrary, is the mark of diabolic. It shows itself by an independent spirit. So, ano yung ano? Sign na it is from the demon. Mas mataas pa siya sa CCC. Mataas pa siya sa katekism. Okay? So, paano natin malaman? Una ito, pride. Independent spirit with regard to superiors and directors. Independent spirit, hindi makinid sa kanilang superior. Independent spirit. By obstinacy in one's opinions. So, parang firm na siya sa kanyang opinion. By refusal to submit to the necessary examination, and by anger. Grabe silang galit kapag merong mag-question. Galit sila. So, for example, in the Philippines, we may have a group led by a supposed visionary. By then, when the diocesan bishop creates a commission to review it, the group's members react in arrogance and anger. Yan ang nangyari ni Father Kabading, no? Believing themselves superior and above suspicion. No. Sila po yung ano, superior and above suspicion. Hindi yan makinig. Yan. Walay kayo na sa grupong iyan, ha? Yung messages nila, kung nagagalit ka ngayon, nakikinig sa akin, ayan, palatandaan po yan. When instructions are given by the bishop to regulate the group, the members do not follow. Ano? the members do not follow, stating that they have better sense. They are being led by God Himself. Ang Diyos ang nag-guide sa amin na mataas po sa obispo, mataas po sa spiritual director namin, mataas po sa mga pari. Yan. Sa demonyo na po yan, ha? The spiritual director given by the bishop to assist the group is forced by the members to follow their lead instead of the other way around, telling the priest that he must have faith in the visionary. You tell him that his doubts regarding the visionary are the same as doubting God Himself. May arrogance na. Arrogance, pride, confusion can only come from the evil one. Take note, ha? Take note po. Such arrogance, pride, and confusion can only come from the evil one. Malinaw na malinaw po yan. With regards to the person of the visionary, the author states that it is a sign of pride and therefore of illusion to have a craving to divulge the graces that we believe ourselves to have received. He adds that humility leads to their concealment, except in the somewhat rare cases of the real utility. A visionary, therefore, who manifests the desire to the center of attention is not led by the divine spirit. Siya na yung center of attention, center of attraction. It is not the Holy Spirit, mga kapatid. Malinaw ba yan, ha? And then, saints would always desire to remain hidden due to humility. This led by the evil spirit desire to even become a spectacle to those around, showing off powers, signs of times. So yung mga santo ay tahimik lang. Humble. Hindi tahimik, humble. Pero yung demonyo pala, show powers, signs, and wonders. No? Sila yung highlights. Hindi na yung kapangyarihan ng mga pari po. Through the sacraments. So, kung there are spectacles, showing off, no? Likado po tayo. Hindi po tayo sa Diyos yan. Father Pauline S.J. asked this important question with regards to the mystic. Has the person taken three precautions that are regarded as indispensable for the avoidance of illusion, fearing to be deceived? Ito po, maganda po ito. Has the person taken three precautions that are regarded as indispensable avoidance of illusions? Fearing to be deceived, perfect frankness with directors, and abstaining from desiring this revelation. It is clear, first of all, that to believe oneself to be safe from illusion is an excellent disposition from suffering from them. So, parang hindi tayo mabiktima sa illusion, no? Kailangan that to believe oneself to be safe from illusions is an excellent disposition from suffering from them. Manifestation of conscience is necessary. In such difficult matters, we must not be both judge and one of the parties concerned. The devil dissuades us from this sincerity for says Saint Ignatius, he is afraid to see his wiles unmasked, and he abhors such an act of humility. In revenge, he leads us to unbosom ourselves without any reflection to friends who have no authority over us, which enable us to put their advice aside if it is not pleased to us. On the other hand, humble souls avoid publicity as much as possible. So unang-una, delikado po yung yung believe oneself to be safe from illusion is an excellent disposition for suffering from them. It is clear. So, unang-una, ang totoong visionary, hindi niya ipagkalat yung vision niya. Dahil hindi pa sigurado na galing sa Diyos yun. On the other hand, na kung may mag-advise sa kanya, contrary sa kanya, kukontrahin niya. Which enables us to put their advice aside if it does not please us. On the other hand, humble souls avoid publicity as much as possible. So ito po, full of pride, no? Kung full of pride yung visionary na sinasamahan mo, mag-isip ka na, mga kapatid. Magduda ka na. Magduda ka na, kapatid. Okay? The desire of revelation also exposes to the soul of to deception. Kung may desire ka na, kung may desire ka na, gusto ko nito. Gusto ko na makausap ang Mama Mary natin. It causes us to find 1,000 subtleties by which to substantiate the vision that we believe ourselves to have had and excites the imagination to invite new ones. The desire of revelation also exposes the soul to deception. Nahihingin mo yung revelation ng malay na katulad, sana makatulad ako ni Saint Bernadette, sana makatulad ako ni Saint Francis, ni Jacinta, ni Lucia. I would like to add other points of reference. Ang ganda nito, ha? So it is all about discerning private revelation. Nandito pa tayo sa una, no? So, yan. First, one must check when and how did the supposed revelation begin. This is important because the presence of the occult in the beginning makes it automatically not of God. Kung meron siyang mga occult involvement, yung mga ninuno niya, automatic po yan. Nandito po yan, ha? Automatically not from God. Examples are when a person goes to Mount Banahaw, galing ako sa Mount Banahaw, and after that performs a ritual to get in touch with the world of spirit, suddenly an apparition of an angel appear to him with a message, or someone is practicing yoga meditation, o kasali pala itong yoga meditation, and repeating a mantra, then suddenly hears a voice claiming to be his guardian angel. Another example would be a person in science suddenly states that the Blessed Virgin Mary is present on his heart to give the group a message. These are not definitely from God. So ina-add ni Father Sikiya, the manifestation of conscience, and then first of all, that you believe oneself to be safe from illusions. It is an excellent yung pinapaniwalaan mo yung sarili mo na, no? Higit sa lahat. Manifestation of conscience, yung konsensya natin, full of pride na. Humble souls avoid publicity as much as possible. Yan po. The desire for revelation also exposes the soul of deception. And then, may additional pa si Father Sikiya, kung the importance, kailan niya nagsimula yung revelation, kung may occult opening yan, automatically from God. Second, is to discover whether the person of the visionary is psychic or occult. Terms has a third eye. Demons can easily manifest themselves to such people. And of course, easily appear as a divine being. There is more probability of deception. yung hupid yung psychic niya. Makakita siya ng mga multo, makakita siya ng mga evil spirit. Oy, no, tumakas ka na dyan. So yun lang sa muna yung una, ha. Bukas na yung pangalawa. Ito po ang basic guidelines of the discerning private revelation. I-summarize natin, ha. Kilalanin natin yung persona. Yung persona, moral life niya, and then yung virtues being possessed by him or by her, and then dahil yung virtues niya ay ordinary lang. Hindi sinasabi dito superficial yung virtue niya. Hindi yung solid virtues na tumutubo sa atin. And then ano pa? Nakikita mo yung arrogance, present yung arrogance, kung questionin sila, magagalit, hindi papalo sa mga direct, spiritual director, lagi silang mataas. Yan po. Manifestation of conscience, no? Yung nakikita yung pride. Yung desire nila to seek more revelation. It is a prone for deception. And then may occult contamination. So, kung ma-examine natin yan, yan. Palatandaan na hindi galing sa Diyos. It is not from God. Fighting Maria, the tax FD, with a humble heart po. God bless.